Today's subject is Health Education and Community Pharmacy, and we will see the chapter number 2, that is Nutrition and Health. And in this lecture, we will see the protein deficiency diseases, that is the disease called as marasmus. The disease marasmus is the deficiency of the protein due to the severe nutrition. Then the incidence of marasmus is high when as compared to the kwashiorkor. So there are two protein deficiency diseases. The first is kwashiorkor and second is the marasmus. Then the marasmus is high, incidence of marasmus is high as compared to the kwashiorkor deficiency disease condition. Then it occurs in the second 6 month of the life. This is the important, it occurs in second 6 month of life. Then this marasmus is occurs due to the diet very low in both protein and calories. Then this is the protein deficiency disease, that is marasmus, and this is occurs due to the diet very low in case of the both protein as well as the calories in the form of nutrients and vitamins. Then what is the cause of marasmus? The first, the child is weaned. Weaned means to stop the mother milk early and fed with the very dilute cow's milk. Means the other diet is given to the child but stopped to the mother milk. It is called as weaned early and it is fed with very dilute cow's milk. So there is an the proper nutrition is not provided to the child. Then second cause, the mother may go to the work leaving the baby with old grandmother, sister and neighborhoods. Means mother not directly care to the child, and it depends on old grandmother, sister and neighborhoods, and therefore so the child is not properly cared and fed because it is dependent to mother, and therefore also diarrhea occurs due to the poor hygiene. So these are the causes of the marasmus. You have to see next is the features. Then first, that in this the marasmus condition, if the deficiency of protein occurs and marasmus can occurs, then what is the conditions? The first, the child is very thin with no subcutaneous fat. Means child is very in thin condition because there is no subcutaneous fat on the skin or on the body. The first condition is the child is very thin. Then second, the muscles are severely wasted. The muscles of severely wasted mean it is the one type of muscle atrophy. In this there is no physical exercise and the mobility of the muscles cannot be takes place. In this condition the muscles are then wasted in condition. It is not in proper proper parameters. Then the next condition is the ribs are protruding. Protruding means the ribs are not uneven. Protruding means uneven condition. And abdomen is distended. Distended means it is extended or it is swelled. And next condition is the limbs look like sticks. Means both arms and legs are look like sticks. There is no subcutaneous fat and these are very thin in nature and this is look like the sticks. And the buttocks are boggy. Boggy means it is too much wet or too much muddy. Then the next is, unlike kwashiorkor, there is no edema and hair changes, but in this marasmus condition there is no edema, means swelling cannot occur to the body, and there is no color change of the hairs as compared to the kwashiorkor. Then next is, the weight of the child reduced below the 60% because there is no subcutaneous fat in the body or in the skin. Therefore the weight of the child reduced to below 60% and there is a diarrhea. Then there is a dehydration, means loss of electrolytes or loss of water from the body, and vitamins deficiency. These are the features of the marasmus. The first are, important is, child is very thin, because there is no subcutaneous fat. This is the first feature. Then second is the muscles are severely wasted. This is called as the muscle atrophy. In this condition, the mobility of the muscles cannot be expressed due to the no physical work has done. Therefore, muscles are wasted. Then the ribs are protruding, means ribs are uneven in condition, and abdomen is distended, meaning it is swell or extended. Then the limbs look like stipe because there is no subcutaneous fat or there is deficiency of proteins, and the buttocks are boggy. The boggy means it is too much wet or too much muddy. Then there is no oedema in the body and no hair color changes. Then in this condition there is no subcutaneous fat, therefore the weight of the child reduced to below 60%, and there is a diarrhea, dehydration and vitamin deficiency. Then next we have to see the management of marasmus disease. The management of marasmus is the same as compared to the Kwashiorkor disease conditions. The same management means we have to provide the protein properly to the body and other nutrients and vitamins. Then next is the prevention process. The prevention means the first family planning to restrict the number of children. This is the first prevention, means number of children can be restricted with the family planning. Second, immunization of the child. Proper immunization is done to the child to protect from the certain disease conditions. And third, encouraging breastfeeding. The mother can give the breastfeeding to the child up to the several years. Then attending maternity, means for the mother care, and child health clinics is properly attending for the this marasmus condition, and also the ICDs centers. So these are the prevention. Then in this lecture we have to see about the marasmus disease, that is protein deficiency disease condition. We have to see the first introduction, what is the marasmus, second what is the causes, then next features, management, and last is the prevention.